Well, this is a supplemental to the earlier video. Can see something quite bizarre is going on here. Seems to be collecting some kind of, or accumulating some kind of stabilizing force, and it's just multiplying itself over and over. Since I have no power, I can't turn off the SAS. So I guess, and I can't even deploy the solar cells now. Well, I guess, back to the drawing board. Although, it is rather promising. Trying to have to think a bit on what I can possibly do to stabilize this thing a bit better. I think it's just the SAS not realizing it's out of power and it's trying to correct itself. It's overcompensating every time. And it just builds up more and more. Oh well, it doesn't hurt anything. I'll leave it tumbling like this around the sun for now. And get back to our ship to Eve. Gonna do a mid-course. Not this one, although this one's heading to Eve as well. This is a probe that was launched much earlier. That's the one we want. Make our mid-course correction again and try to get our periapsis down into the atmosphere for some aero-braking fun. 7 minutes. Let's see if we can. How we can do this. Nope, that didn't do it. What do I have to do to make this lower? 28. Everything seems to be making it worse. Huh. How about that? No. What about this? Not better. Okay, this direction seems to be better. Not really. Huh. What do I have to do to get this thing to go lower? Might have to wait till it gets closer to here and burn in the retrograde. Let's see. I'm kind of on the descending. It looks like I'm passing on the night side. So, looks like I'm passing on the southern or the Antarctic pole, and then it's throwing me up into a more inclined orbit. So trying to figure out what kind of maneuver I need to do here to get my periapsis down. Ah, here we go. 6, 5. So let's set this a little bit further back. Well, no. As long as we're outside of Eve's influence, cost and delta V shouldn't change. So let's set this as close as we can get it. And I'm gonna aim for about a, I think 80,000 meter altitude. To do the aero braking. So this is gonna throw me into a polar orbit. Kind of makes me wish I brought along a altitude scanner, so then I could at least get a low res scan of the surface, get a sense of the bumpiness, or see what mountains are on there and all that jazz. Oh well, I don't think I have one on the probe either. Well, another probe, I guess, or another trip. Don't worry, we'll be back soon enough. Well, now we're crashing into it. So, let's give ourselves some padding here. Let's see, 9 days, 7 days. Let's give our 3-day buffer. That way I can make some more fine-tuning adjustments as we get closer. But so far it's looking pretty good. Oh well. The delta V cost is a lot less the further out you get. So let's do it sooner rather than later. One day, 9 hours. Oops. Let's see, 80. One 80 kilometer parapsis. Set it for that, and we'll make another adjustment when we get closer. Now, where would I maneuver? Would my maneuver node be burning towards the north, I think. There it is. Get our legs settled down here. Don't get too jittery. I don't think you'll be landing anywhere. Sorry to disappoint you guys. But honestly, I don't think you guys are up to the task. At least not for a ship this size. Now let's add ourselves an alarm. It's going to be a very short burn, so 5 minutes should be good. Now we just fast forward. Let's see. Make sure we got the right maneuver going here. 100 716,000 meters per apsis. And 1 minute to go. This will be short and quick. Well, that's a huge difference. Doing it out here versus all the way in there. That was a 70 meter per second difference. Wow. Let's do another quick one here. Bring our parapsis down to where we want it. Let's see, it's 300 now, so it's getting tough to see though. Well, I wouldn't even need this. I'll just burn, change my inclination, and pay attention to that. Okay, we're going to be passing in the atmosphere. I'll make another adjustment later on, get it around 80. Oh hell, let's do it now. Let's see, what is that, 81? Actually, this is where RCS comes in handy. Should have thought of it. Let's see. Although this wobbliness is making it tough to read. Make up your mind. 70, 80, 90, what? Okay, looks like we're around 90. Jeez. This will have to do for now. And just before we go, we're gonna dump our accumulated junk from the last couple weeks. It must be getting pretty raunchy in that spacesuit at this point. So let's clear some stuff out. Wastewater. Dump. CO2. And dump. Alright. Now Anlorf is ready for Eve.